Hello, I am Mr. DJ Doshi, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we will be learning about projection of solids. At the end of this session, students will be able to draw the projections of solids as per given conditions. Now this is the given problem. Draw the plan and elevation of a cube of solid diagonal 80 mm length when the solid diagonal is perpendicular to the VP and the corner of the cube is in HP. Initially, we will first discuss about what is plan, what is elevation. Now, plan is a top view, elevation is a front view. So, this word we have not yet come across. So, plan is the top view and elevation is the front view. Now, later on, cube we know, of which all the faces are square. Cube is a, all the faces are square where there are 4 plus 2, 6 faces. Okay. And what is solid diagonal? Solid diagonal is a diagonal drawn across as a diagonal joining the line opposite corners of different faces, that is base and face, and the corners opposite to each other will be joined. So, it will be called as a solid diagonal. Now, here the length of the solid diagonal is given as 80 mm. So, how will you calculate then the base edges? So, for that the formula is length of solid diagonal is root 3 into base side. So, this is the formula you have to remember if you are attempting the problem related to solid diagonal. So, solid diagonal is equal to root 3 into base edge length. Then the problem becomes simple. Now, we want the solid diagonal to be perpendicular to VP and the corner of the cube is in HP. So, here from this we will understand that its top view will be a square and the front view will be a rectangle. Now, while drawing the square, we have to draw in such a way that the solid diagonal must be parallel to the HP when we will go for second stage. So, that is 1, 3 will be the solid diagonal which will be parallel to HP in second stage. So, here you have to draw the top view in such a way that the base edges will be making angle, equal angle or 45 degree angle with VP. So, we have drawn a square as a top view here. So, base 3, 4 is making 45 degree and 1, 4 is making 45 degree. So, we have to draw a square in such a way that all the base edges will be making 45 degree with VP. So, project it upwards, that is project 1 upwards, project 2 and 4 upwards and project 3 upwards. You will get a top view of the same height again, that is which we have calculated that. That is 80 is equal to root 3 into base edge. So, base edge will be equal to 80 divided by root 3. So, that length we have calculated. Now, see sometimes we will name the top face as ABCD and the base as 1, 2, 3, 4. But here we have given the names as 1, 2, 3, 4 both. So, 1, 2, 3 is a base, 1, 2, 3, 4 is a base and 1, 2, 3, 4 is a top surface. Okay. Now, we have drawn the projections. 1, 1 dash will be equal to the length we have calculated base edge. Similarly, 3, 3 dash will be of same length, 2, 2 dash and 2, 4 dash will be of the same length. So, we have completed a rectangle which will be a front view of a cube. Now, what is solid diagonal? As I told you, it is a diagonal joining the corners which are opposite or diagonally opposite to each other on different faces. So, this is a base and this is a top face of which one is on the base and 3 is on the top face, which will, if we join this 1, 3, it will be a solid diagonal. So, I have joined the solid diagonal as 1, 3 and completed the front view. So, now of course, 1, 3 will be a thin line as it is a construction line. Now, what is first, second stage, that is solid diagonal is perpendicular to VP. Okay. So, to make it perpendicular to VP, we will rotate the front view in such a way that the 1-3 or 1-3 will be parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP. Okay. So now here we will rotate in such a way that, of course, another condition is the corner must be on HP. So the corner is on HP, so 3- will remain on HP, and we will rotate in such a way that the solid diagonal will be parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP. So now the difficult part here is construction of the front view or rotation of the front view to get the 1-3 parallel. So for that, what we have done, 1-3 is a solid diagonal. We have drawn a perpendicular from 3- to the solid diagonal. So here we will take a point on XY line, that is 3-, draw a line perpendicular to it of the same length, that is 3- and this length, and draw a horizontal line or a perpendicular line to it such a way that this distance will be equal to this distance here and this distance will be equal to this here, and join the edges and complete the view such that the solid diagonal is parallel to HP. Now project it upwards, project it downwards, one projected downwards, and accordingly we will project 1, 2, 3, 4 of the base and 1, 2, 3, 4 of the top face downwards. Now here when we join the points 1, 2, 3, 4 as a base and 1, 2, 3, 4 as a top face, if you observe, now the observer is from here, observing from here, so this will be totally visible. So the top face will be totally visible to the observer, so we will join 1, 2, 3, 4 as a dark line. Now when you observe from here, this 1-2 and 1-4 will be also visible. So 1-4 and 1-2 is joined with a dark line. Join 4-4-1, 1-1 and 2-2. Now as the point 3 is away from the observer, the lines related to 3 will be dotted lines. Now what are the lines related to 3? It is 3-4, 3-2 and 3-3. So while drawing, you have to draw these lines 3-4, 3-3 and 3-2 as dotted lines. Okay. Now why these are the lines dotted lines? You think over it. As we have observed it from the top, the point is away from the observer is 3. So lines related to 3 will be dotted. Now next part. So this is related to HP, that is the corner is resting on HP. And of course, this is made parallel to HP. Now our next step is the solid diagonal is perpendicular to VP. Now pause the video and think it, that how we can make the solid diagonal perpendicular to VP. Yes, now see, what is the solid diagonal? 1-3. So here it is 3. And here it is 1. Okay. So this 1 and this 3, if you join, this is called as a solid diagonal or top view of a solid diagonal. Now we have to make it perpendicular to VP. Now as this 1-3 is parallel to HP, of course this here 1-3 will be the true length line. So there is no necessity to think of whether the solid diagonal is true or not. So it is of course a true length line, so we will make it perpendicular. So now here we will rotate this top view of the second stage such that 1-3 will be perpendicular to VP. So we have rotated it such that 1-3 is perpendicular to it. Redraw this sketch same again. So take a point 1 here, draw a 1-3 perpendicular to it, draw the required angles and all these things. We have to copy it here. Accordingly we will make the line. Now here also 3-4 and 3-2 are dotted. So here I have drawn 3-4, this one, and 3-2 and 3-3 as a dotted line. Now I will project 2-2 here, 2-2, 4-4, 3-3 and 1-1 above. Projected horizontal, so 1- and projector from 1, we will get 1- of the top face, 2- and 2 from here, so you will get 2- out of the top face, 4- and 4 from here, you will get 4- for the top face, and remaining is 3. So 3 is also projected from here. Of suppose that will be on the same line. 3-3 and 1-1 are on the same line, so 3 dash you will get here. So I will join 1-2-3-4. Now, as we are observing from this side, the lines which are related to 1 will be dotted. See, because you are observing from here, 1 is away from the observer. So 1-2 and 1-4 and 1-1 will be dotted lines. So now this is the bottom face. So we have projected it upwards. We project it horizontally. You will get again 1-2-3-4 or 1-2-3-4-. Join accordingly. Now this face related to this will be a dark line. Then, as I told you, as this point 1 is away from the observer, so this one and this one will be the dotted line. So 1-1-, then 2-4-, and 2-2-, will be the dotted lines. So join this with the dotted lines, and other things will be joined as the dark line. So this is the final view of the cube. Solid diagonal is 80 mm, whose solid diagonal is perpendicular to VP, and whose corner of the base is resting on HP. So this, for this refer the book Engineering Drawing by Mr. P.H. Jain. Thank you.